Hello, beautiful souls. I am Awakened Soul. Today we'll be looking at XRP and creating a 4-hour Joe target. We're going to start off at our 2-week by creating our support and resistance trend lines so we could focus where price action is taking place at this moment. So once we're done doing that, let's go ahead and move on to our daily. Within the daily time frame, we're gonna create our daily range. Low, and this is our high. If you have a hard time finding your high or low, I like to use our pivot high and lows to confirm. So this wick right here is throwing me off a little bit, but it is what it is, so we're gonna mark it. So this is our daily range that we're playing within. Within that, we find our daily trend lines. Using 2 points, see, I don't like that. What about here? Yeah, that's good enough for me. So we have our daily range, we have our daily wedge. Let's go ahead and mark our POC, points of control. You could definitely use any VPVR indicator. I like to use 2 just to confirm where my POC will be located. And it looks like price action is right on it. So let's go ahead and mark it and remove the indicator. Okay, so we have our daily wedge, our daily range, we have our daily POC. Now let's go ahead and move down to the 4 hours. Once we're in the 4 hours, now that we're in our 4 hour time frame, we're going to go ahead and find our POC again, just like we did in the daily range. And it looks like it's located right where the daily POC is, a little bit lower. So let's go ahead and mark it. Let's change the colors here. Let's work with gray now. Okay, let's find our 4 hour range. Our high, our low. Now that we're here, let's go ahead. So this is our range. Let's do our trend lines on the 4 hour. I'm gonna do something. Okay, so again, I use our pivot highs and lows to help me draw those trend lines. Two touches. Two touches here. One, two. So our wedge is indicating that price action has broken to the upside, creating a new higher high. It is getting rejected off the 200 EMA. So if this doesn't hold up, we could say 3381. Yeah, it's in an uptrend right now. So let's find a target, because if it could bounce off our EMA, and again I use the 12 and the 26, so if it's finding support here, it'll continue to the upside. And our Joe target would be based on this wedge. First touch, second touch, you look right in between to the lowest price. And the lowest price will be this wick down here. So you just mark it. And this would be my target. This is my 4-hour target. And let's say we break down, right? It could be a fake out, then a breakdown to the downside. My target would be 1.2 touch, the highest price. And there you go. This would be my bearish target, and this will be my bullish target. And that is in the 4-hour time frame. You also want to look at your RSIs to see if you identify any divergence, see any oversold, any overbought price action. Like to start from the daily here. Okay. Oops. Switch the 4-hour. A lot of volatility coming in. So either we hold our 26 EMA here, like I said, finding that support and continuation to the upside, or we continue to the downside. Anything is possible, but remember to do everything with love. And that's your targets, guys. May the force be with you.